How are you amazing people on the internet doing out there? We are on the fourth day of the Flutter Firebase app development series. What did we do yesterday? We were stressed out to the max, even though you guys weren't. I was stressed out to the max. It was really, really difficult to make this thing work. Importantly, the SQL FLE DB, the Firebase, two different DBs, handling them in the proper way and making the application work was very difficult yesterday. But we went through that and we did that properly. You can find the code samples in the description that I've put. I've put the link in the description for the GitHub repository. Go find that. In today's video, I understand that you, from your guys' reaction, that this UI is not really good. I mean, it's not even good at all. I've got a very basic font. I've got a very basic color. I mean, we just made the working part of it, but we did not do the design part of it. So that is what we're going to be concentrating on today's work. Today's going to be completely dedicated to improving the UI, the UX, and also probably maybe if possible, I'll squeeze in the sharp button plugin that I was talking to you guys in the stand-up. So today we'll just look at the UI and UX part. I'm going to be adding fonts and the colors and making sure that this looks much better. And probably starting from now on, you're going to see me jamming the keyboard and probably finish that part right now. I'll meet you guys. I'll be taking that part and putting it here, so I cannot talk to the camera. So, alright, I cannot talk to the camera. I'll make sure that you guys can see the screen. Let me meet you guys at the end of this part. Primarily for me, everything is about font and the UI and the colors. Like we talked about in the stand-up, it isn't really possible to create something that looks like a well-researched design, like how big companies like UX and UI design companies, like even for Google, they create an application anywhere from 6 to 1 year. 6 months to 1 year is a huge time for dedicating to one single application. They do a lot of research before doing that. And comparing that to our application here is just for 5 days. We have a less than 15 hour schedule to complete the application. Flutter is going to stand up for that, but will the design part also stand up is the question. Let's not stress too much on the design, because for me personally, I always feel that the application should first work. The application should do everything and anything without disturbing the flow of the actual application's work. If it is completely without bugs, then you start working on the UX. But you definitely have to work on the UX. You cannot release an application that looks something like this. So definitely 1 day of effort is required, but not trading 20 to 30% of the entire work schedule for this. So yeah, that is the plan for me. That's what I have been having ever since I started these series of videos. But in case an application's time is anywhere from 8 weeks of development period, then maybe I would spend 2 weeks into researching the color palettes properly, putting the fonts in places. I would spend some more time watching or looking at different ideas for designing. And all of that will happen. But since this is not a very big application that we're developing, just because it is primarily looked at in terms of something that we have to make this thing work in the first place, and this isn't something that you find in every day. There aren't any code repositories with the working Flutter application that does this. There is nothing like a feedback application that's going to do this. So it's new from us. It's something from scratch. Always fun to do things from scratch. And that's why you're not doing. So what is the plan is, I've already taken a couple of fonts. This is my favorite font. Poppins is my favorite font. I've taken that. I've looked at some inspirations for list view. And we're just going to stick everything together. And probably this application would look different. I'll also be changing the input tags and input fields here. And we'll do a lot of such important things. By end of this breezy 2 to 3 minutes, you will see me doing that. And we'll discuss what I did that after that. Alright, so probably I'm guessing the application is done for me for right now. This is how it looks. A couple of list views that's popping up with the drop shadow, and this is the input text. This is how the input text field looks like. And pretty much that is it. That is how the entire application is going to look like. We have stuck to the selected color, which is the teal, and complementary colors like this cream and a little bit of coral for this, giving this complement feel. Again, here sticking with the same color palette, nothing big change of them. So this is going to send feedback, it's going to send And that is it. That is how we have designed the UX. I'm going to be submitting this for today's commit. What else is remaining is we have still yet to finish the initial flow as in the data flow from opening, which is nothing but this type. This field consists of pretty much a lot of colors. Hopefully we can style this as well, and I'll show you guys the entire thing by end of this again. Alright, so we're done an application. Probably this is how it looks right now. We've added some colors, fonts, and improved how the application looks overall. We'll just take the entire, we'll go through the entire flow right from the application starting, and we'll see how it looks. So first page is like this, favorite color, you'll enter the favorite color. Click the next button if you want to, just do this. You can go and finally click the skip button. In this enter user ID, I'm going to say Android Monks, probably 5, I don't know, some number like this. And you click done, is asking for the are you sure about Android Monks 5. I'm saying sure. It's going to take some time, connect the DB, it's going to look, and it goes and connects with the DB. And this is the welcome page for us. It says welcome, message received recently, and the page looks like this. So switch to send page, and it asks for user ID, message, you can send feedback. You know, let me send a message to myself. Test message. And click send feedback. Something probably broke somewhere. Just enter box 5 and we'll go here. Test message. Click send feedback. Might need to have a callback here, but let me check this out. Alright, so I received a lot of test messages. Probably I should have had a callback here, which will just do spin and say that yes, message is sent or something like that. It will help the user. Probably we'll do that tomorrow's video, because tomorrow is going to be about testing how are the UX performing across the application. So we'll do that for tomorrow. I'll have it as in tomorrow's backlog. And that is it for the UI UX part of the application. Probably we transform something from that looked like this to something that looked like this right now. So it's really important that you understand that colors play a very important role in improving the user's usability. Even though this is not like a extremely premium type of an application, we have just still improved the application. We still improved the UI, we still improved the UX, and people are going to click on things. They're going to try things as soon as they see the popping colors out. Alright, so that's it for the UI and UX part of today's video. Tomorrow is going to be the final day. Add some sample, add some testing codes. We'll just do some testing for tomorrow and release the application in the App Store. It's going to be pretty interesting, pretty wild. Do not forget to check tomorrow's videos out. I'll just make sure that the stand-ups and the video itself are actually released properly on time. And it'll be really interesting to see how tomorrow pans out. Alright, so that's it from me. Today's video is informative as well. I hope it was. And if you find it informative, do not forget to smash that subscribe button somewhere down there. And peace out from me.